I play a guy who is dating Bryan Cranston's daughter. I'm a video game app designer. I'm very successful, but I'm a little unpolished and rude, and I have a lot of tattoos and use crude language, and so I'm everything that Bryan Cranston's character wouldn't want in a son, or he's, you know. And so I ask him for his blessing because I want to ask his daughter to marry me, and he refuses. And so I spend our Christmas holiday trying to win him over. Essentially, Laird is not a bad guy. He's like a really nice guy. And so I just said, you know, John, we need this guy, at least initially, to be very frightening to a father, you know? And one of the ways to do that is to make his exterior seem frightening, because actually inside he's everything that you'd probably want in a, you know, a son-in-law. And there was this gag that we had been wrestling with from the beginning about Laird trying to do something and when he initially meets the family that he thinks is a sort of a gesture of solidarity or, you know, and or welcome, and they read it completely differently. And so there were a lot of different incarnations of that, and finally we settled on the idea that he would get a tattoo of the family on his back, and then John added on that he just had a holiday card of the family. That's the photo that he used, and so the tattoo artist put in happy holidays. I think he really had a blast on this because he hasn't really done comedy since Malcolm in the Middle, and which is what, over 10 years ago. And so I think it was a real, I think he had a great time actually. And you wouldn't expect that Bryan is sort of the one to like push the envelope. Like, he always makes a suggestion that's for a scene that's just too far. Not only for his character, but for everybody. And I love that. I mean, I love that it's Bryan. John works in a similar way to, you know, what I do on the Seth Rogen movies. There is a lot of room for improvisation. You know, you start with the script and then sort of roll from there and see what you find. And you, I guess you always want, in that situation, you always want somebody that can give good suggestions. You know, if you're riffing and then they can sort of build on that, you want somebody like that behind the camera to kind of help support you. Originally, sort of the big moose scene, you know, and the fight and that leads to the moose tank was so much simpler. And I remember John saying on that day, like when the, after the whole great room is flooded with, you know, the moose water and the moose has come out and the balls are in Scotty's face, that John kept saying, you know, originally this was so simple. It was just Ned kicking the sculpture, nothing happens, and he walks out. And it turned into this whole fight and parkour in the living room and falling into the moose tank. And it's just perfect, because it's, you know, it's all the different threads that we've been developing throughout the movie kind of come together in that moment. I think the first thing that brought me to the movie was John Hamburg. He was actually my teacher at NYU when I was there for the graduate filmmaking program, and he unfortunately was my teacher the semester that I was doing 127 hours, so I wasn't there a lot, but we talked a lot, and I got to know him on the phone. But he was sort of the initial thing that drew me to it. I liked his movies and liked his writing, and then I heard, he told me that he was thinking about Bryan Cranston for the father role, and I saw Bryan. I didn't know Bryan, but I saw him backstage on the last episode of the Colbert Report. And he said, hey, I heard you might do this and I might do it. What do you think? And so we started talking, and he's just Bryan Cranston is just the greatest human being ever.